mind right now, what do you think of the team's shape at this stage as we head into Mexico?
I think right now we seem on track. I think the players, they have the right attitude towards this tournament. They've been working hard together as a team. They understand the importance of working together as a team to get one common result. Of course, we have to see our opponents, see what they're like. We are familiar with them. We've played against Mexico, Costa Rica and Guatemala before. But I think the whole atmosphere is the right atmosphere going into this tournament.
Are you in a position right now to compare your last under 17 team with this team? Would it be attitude-wise, potential-wise?
I think potentially they're both very similar. They work hard. They understand why they're working hard. I think they realize to get any type of success, they must work hard together as a team. And it's very similar. Of course, you have players that will have a little bit more potential at this time, a little bit more ability, and we hope that these players will step up and carry some of the weight. But it's going to take 20 players to qualify, really 27 players to qualify, and they have been pushing each other, and we hope that can go from practice into the game situations.
All right, let's take one game at a time now. In the first game against Mexico, what would be your approach facing a Mexican team in their own backyard? They haven't qualified for the last under 17 World Championship, and we faced them in a couple of friendlies last time around. How do you see this affair?
It's going to be tough playing in Mexico, but we plan to be very disciplined, especially in defense. Stay in the game for as long as we can stay in the game, and I'm pretty much confident with our fitness and our hunger for results that it's possible for us to get a very good result against them. Of course, it's not going to be easy. We can't expect Mexico to roll over. That's not going to happen, especially looking back at the U17 results the last time and then U20 here. We expect this Mexican team to come at us, but I think if we play well, if we remain disciplined, if we take responsibility, I think we can do well against them.
What will you tell your players, though, facing a Mexican team at home? Obviously, the atmosphere is going to be one of those that they wouldn't have really been accustomed to in the past.
It's 11v11. It's 1v1 battles all over the field. And we have to accept those battles and carry those battles to Mexico. It's not about who's in the stands. It's not about who sits on the bench, what coach they have. It's all about winning your 1v1 battles. And it's going to come down to one team against the other on that day, and we are prepared for that.
Gerald, obviously, going into the tournament, we've come down to the stages, the final round of the qualifiers, and you've been with the team for a while now. What are your expectations?
Well, the team have worked very hard. The coaches have pushed us all the way, and I feel we are very positive in going into this tournament, and we're going to qualify.
What do you think would be the key for us, though? I mean, obviously, we're facing the best of Concacaf in Mexico, our first game against Mexico. What would our approach be like? What should it be like?
Well, our approach, we have prepared enough. Study in Mexico, not as much as other teams, Mexico especially. And we know our key going into this thing is our speed. That's what we are going to use to beat this team.
You think we're disciplined enough to go into a competition like this and play for 90 minutes in the three matches?
Yes, the coach has taught us enough, and they have given us enough knowledge to go and be well organized and come out victorious.
You in particular, one of the most senior players in the team because of your experience, having been abroad in England and stuff like that. How do you think you're going to pass this on for the rest of the team, and obviously you have to lead by example?
Yeah, well, the coaches have talked to me on many occasions, and knowing that I have the most experience on this team, they have always taught me to hand over the experience that I have to the younger players coming up.
What is the latest with that, though?
Well, the latest call I got is that the agent told us that they want us to sign in August.
In August.
We will be into the youth academy, going into reserve, then to the senior team.
All right, great. Best wishes. Thanks.
Thank you.